As promised, in this video I'm going to show you installation of Greylog for a small environment in which we were going to use a server where we're going to install the Greylog application, Mongo database, Elasticsearch, and something which is not written here or you don't see it in this picture, we will also need Java 8. Down below you can find the links to other types of operating systems. You can also install it on Ubuntu or Debian, CentOS, and you could also install it on a SUSE server. The links are not displayed here, but I'm gonna put it for you down in the description. In these links over here, you're gonna find also the commands that I will use for CentOS. I'm not gonna show you the CentOS installation. Before going to install Greylog, you need to do a couple of things. First one, you need a static IP address. Second, you need a working DNS. Third one, an internet connection. In this window here, I have an SSH connection to my server. And because this is a test environment, I'm going to disable the firewall. If you're going to run this one in production, you might want to keep the firewall enabled. And then using IP tables, you can permit access to the ports that you have opened for Greylog. So I'm going to check first of all the firewall status to see if it's active. And you can see it here that is running. So first of all, I will disable it. And then I will stop it. Now let's just check the status once more. And you can see that it's inactive. Now I will install Java. Hit Y for yes. After the Java installation, I'm gonna also install a password generator tool, which we were going to use it later on when we will edit the configuration file for Greylog. Yeah, first of all I need to install the EPL release. And then I can install the generator. Before installing Greylog and Mongo database, first I'm going to install the Elasticsearch. This command is for the installation of Elastic GPG key. And after this one, we will have to manually create the repos for Elasticsearch. Over here, I'm going to hit I to insert. Hit the escape key and then colon write and quit with an exclamation mark, that means it will be forced. type the command for the Elasticsearch installation. Minus y stands for yes, and save the time for not typing y and then hitting enter every time they were going to ask for permission to install something. After the installation of Elasticsearch, we will need to do some modifications for the Elasticsearch configuration file. And again, I'm going to hit I to edit the file. And I will modify the cluster name to, instead of my application, to Graylog. Then the path of where you're gonna save your logs and data. In case you are running it in production, it's recommended that you will use a different path for Elasticsearch other than the default one. In case you'll need to upgrade the Elasticsearch application, after the upgrade, you're gonna lose your data. So you can do a custom one. Like in my case, I can put here, let's see, let's put Elastic and then data. For the logs, I'm gonna keep it in the same folder, Elastic, and then logs. Delete the hashtag in front of it naturally. Now, if you're gonna run on a SSD or a fast input output like a SAN or an SSD, like I have said, which is my case here, I'm running an SSD on this server, you should start to increase the Indus stored throttle to something like 150 megabytes or a little bit more than this. You can play around with these settings, you know, until you reach some kind of, you know, like the best performance for your case. But usually I keep it to 150 megs. So let me put a command here. I will put it at the very end of the file here, and then I'm going to save it. Because we changed the default path of where you're going to store the data and the logs for Elasticsearch, you'll need to create a folder. So you can go to your root directory and then start to create folder Elastic. We're going to go to this folder and start to create the data in the logs. After you're going to create these folders, you'll notice that the owner of the folders is the root one, and you need to change it to Elasticsearch in order for Elasticsearch to be able to write the data in these folders. So let's change the ownership. Elasticsearch will be our username. And then you have data. We will do the same for logs. And now if you're gonna do an LL, you're gonna see that the username, the ownership of the folders is changed to Elasticsearch. If you're wondering how you can find the user, you can go to check the etc passwords or the password file, you know, which you're gonna find it in the etc. Here you can find Elasticsearch. Now that we have managed to configure the Elasticsearch and install it, it's time to start it. And now let's check the status. And you can see that everything is running fine. More than this, you can also do a curl. And once you're gonna do the curl, you should be able to see something similar to this one. After we have finished everything with Elasticsearch, it's time to install the Mongo database. And before installing Mongo, it's recommended that you're going to do an update of your system. So after the update is complete, it's time to create the repository for Mongo. Then save the file. Now install the Mongo database. For a small server, you don't need to edit anything regarding Mongo database, so you can start the service. Right now, let's check the status. And it's running really nice. After we have done all of this, it's time to install the Greylog application. First, we would need to import the repositories. And now we can install the application. We should start to generate some passwords, or actually generate only one password. Okay, save this password on a file. I will save it in a text file. You're gonna need it later. And now we need to generate a SHA-256 sum for the password that we were gonna use for the admin user in Greylog to log in. So for that one, we were gonna use echo. And for password, I'm gonna choose something like something very basic, like pass 123 space pipe SHA 256 sum and hit enter. And this hash again, you'll need to save it in a text file. Since we have done all of this, it's time to edit the Greylog configuration file. Hit I. And we will start to search for the secret password. We will use the password which was generated by the tool first time, first password. Okay, then we will check for the root password for Greylog. Okay, it's this one here. And over here, we will need to copy and paste that hash. Next, we will need to delete the hashtag for the root time zone. You can put over here any kind of time zone that you would like. I'm just gonna leave it to the default one, which is UTC, and delete the hashtag in front of it. Okay. Yeah. Next, we will need to check the web listen URI. Delete the hashtag in front of it. And instead of having the loopback address of this one, of this host, I'm gonna put the IP address where the Greylog server will listen for connections, which is in my case 10.100.0.2. Then you'll need to modify the REST listen URI. and I want to put the same IP address. After this, I can save the file. Now we can start the Greylock services. Now we can check the status to see if everything is in order. And it is. Right now we will try to connect to the interface of Greylock server, where it's listening. So let's go to http://10.100.0.2:9000. Okay, it took some time to have the interface starting. And here you can put your username, which I'm gonna use this time for admin. Admin is your default username for Greylock, unless you decide to change it. And then I'm gonna put that password, pass123. And hit enter. And right now you're connected to the interface. And you can start to play with the tool. Right now, I'm not sure if you're gonna notice it, but you will have a problem with Greylock. It says that it's not secure. That is because you are not using HTTP in this case. I'm gonna show you in the next video how you can enable HTTPS for Greylock and explain you bit by bit on how you can configure it. Thanks for watching, and talk to you guys in the next one.